Good morning, students. In the last lecture, we discussed about the application of uniform circular motion. The third application is vehicle running on a banked road. In that equation, we derive an equation for safe speed with which a vehicle can be driven along a curved road. In this section, we are continuing this application, but the condition is different. What is the condition? The condition is that if the safe speed is less than the safe speed and the speed is greater than the safe speed. Okay. Also, in this case, in these two cases, we also take an account the frictional force which is arises between the tires and the surface of the road. Therefore, we are discussing two different conditions when velocity, minimum velocity is less than the safe speed and what is the maximum velocity which is greater than the safe speed. Okay, let's start. When a vehicle is starting or when a vehicle is running on a curved road, the forces acting on this vehicle is as shown in the figure. Which are the forces? Consider the vehicle is of the mass m, therefore the weight of the vehicle is equal to mg, which is always directed in the downward direction. And according to the Newton's third law, for every action there is equal and opposite reaction. Therefore, a normal reaction perpendicular to the road surface arises, which is denoted by letter capital L. This normal reaction is divided into two rectangular components, n cos theta and n sin theta. This n cos theta is directed in the upward direction and this n sin theta it is in the horizontal direction towards the center of the circular path. Now, the frictional force which is arises between the tire and the road surface is along the road surface, tangential to the road surface. This frictional force also divided into two components, Fs sin theta and Fs cos theta. This Fs sin theta is exactly in the upward direction and this Fs cos theta it is in the horizontal direction. Then by this condition we can derive an equation for the minimum velocity with which a vehicle can be driven along a curved road. Let's start. Now, from this diagram we can say that this weight of the body is balanced by n cos theta. So we can write this n cos theta, and a frictional force Fs sin theta is also directed in the upward direction. Therefore, we can write Fs sin theta which is equal to mg. When the two vectors are directed in the same direction, we add them. Such case n cos theta and Fs sin theta add themselves to balance the weight of the body mg. Therefore, n cos theta plus Fs sin theta is equal to mg. Another case arises, that is n sin theta and F cos theta, they are exactly opposite to each other. But the vehicle is running towards the center of the circle with a centripetal force. Therefore, we can write the equation as this N sin theta minus Fs cos theta is equal to the centripetal force, which is equal to mv square minimum divided by r. What is r? R is the radius of the circular path on which this vehicle is running. Therefore, from these two equations, we can determine, let's start, n sin theta minus fs cos theta, and it is divided by n cos theta plus fs sin theta, which is equal to, it is equal to m v square minimum divided by r, and it is totally divided by weight of the body, which is equal to mg. Now here this mm get cancelled. We can therefore write is L sin theta minus fs cos theta divided by L cos theta plus fs sin theta, which is equal to v square minima divided by rg. Now for this side, if we divide each term by n cos theta, then we get n sin theta divided by n cos theta, which is equal to tan theta. Therefore we can write here it is equal to tan theta minus fs cos theta divided by n cos theta. Cos theta get cancelled, is equal to fs divided by n, which is equal to the coefficient of static friction mu s. Therefore it is equal to mu s. Then n cos theta divided by n cos theta is equal to 1 plus again n cos theta divided, then fs divided by n multiplied by sin theta into divided by cos theta, we can write it as mu s multiplied by n theta. So this is the equation for v square minimum divided by rg. So v square or v minimum is equal to under root, this is rg, it is tan theta minus mu s divided by 1 plus mu s tan theta. So this is the equation for the minimum speed with which a vehicle can safely driven along a curved road. Okay, now in the second case, in the second condition, we have to find the maximum speed with which a vehicle can safely driven along the curved road. Let's start. Similarly, in this case, we can determine the balancing condition. Let's start. That is n cos theta, fs sin theta and mg, they are in the direction. Therefore we can write as this n cos theta is balanced by the addition of fs sin theta and plus the weight of the object. Therefore we can write this n cos theta minus fs sin theta is equal to mg. Similarly, in the second case, what happened? This fs cos theta and n sin theta both are directed towards the center of the circular path, and the vehicle is running in the circular path, and for that we need a centripetal force. Therefore, we can write this equation as n sin theta plus fs cos theta, which is equal to the centripetal force, is equal to m maximum, mv maximum square divided by r. What is r? R is the radius of the circular path. Then divide this equation by this equation. Therefore we can write n sin theta plus fs cos theta divided by n cos theta minus fs sin theta, which is equal to, this is equal to v square maximum divided by rg. In the same case, the same condition should be followed here. Each term in this equation is divided by n cos theta. Therefore n get cancelled and sin theta upon cos theta is equal to tan theta plus this fs divided by n cos theta get cancelled, which is also equal to mu s divided by n cos theta upon n cos theta is equal to 1 minus, it is also equal to mu s multiplied by n cos theta, it is equal to v square maximum divided by rg. therefore this v square maximum is equal to rg in bracket tan theta plus mu s divided by 1 minus mu s tan theta, and therefore this v maximum is equal to under root rg in bracket tan theta plus mu s divided by 1 minus mu s tan theta. So the maximum speed with which a vehicle can be safely driven along per road is given by this equation v maximum, and the minimum speed is given by this equation v minimum is equal to this. In this section we discuss about the minimum and maximum speed of the vehicle with which a vehicle can be safely driven along a curved road. In the next section we are discussing about the conical pendulum. For this, okay, bye.